Well, it didn't take long, did it? 6 months roughly after renewing my PPL to be able to fly again, I got reported to the CAA. Yay! In this video, I'm going to be talking to you a little bit about what happened and why somebody decided to report me to the CAA and what happened as a result of it. So yeah, enjoy the video. So the plan for today then was to take my daughter up for her first flight with just me and her in the plane. Take her for a little bit of a local flight, fly over our house, fly over her grandparents' house, and then back to the airfield. Nothing too much, so that it obviously wouldn't be too bad for an 8-year-old to process on her first flight. Now, the first stop today was to fly her over towards her friend's house, where she was going to be taking some pictures out of the window and seeing her friend's house from a plane, which was all very good. So we took off and headed down towards the area where her friend lives so that we could go and have a bit of a fly around and then head off back towards our place, really. And it was quite an easy sort of trip. Are you ready?
Yeah.
Hope you're probably taking off runway 21.
That's a 210 degrees, 11 knots.
You ready?
Yeah.
Let's go.
I'm always ready.
50 knots. 60 knots. So we headed down and started a left circling pattern over the top of where Anna's friend lives. You see them then?
No.
Oh, okay. I can see the conservatory.
That car.
I can see them in the garden. They're waving. There's Sam.
Where?
Down here.
What?
Let me turn around and we'll come back here so you can see them out of your sight, yeah?
Will it be on my side?
It will be in a minute, yeah. Hang on then. So look over that way, behind us. I'm just going to bring the plane back round, okay?
Okay.
And look over there. So these houses down here is where my mum and granddad live. You see them? So there's a bridge over a road. See it? Yeah, the bridge, the car just going under it. Here, look. Just down here. And there's a road that goes up and you can see the conservatory on the back. You see? See it? Just down here. You see? Do you not see it?
No.
I'll show you on the photos in a bit, Tanner, okay? Do you want to go to our house and see our house now?
Yeah.
Yeah, so we're going to go over the windmills. See these windmills down here? They're the big windmills, aren't they? And yeah, it all worked pretty well. We headed down towards the area her friend lived. We circled around a couple of times, went off, got some really nice photos. I had some real quality time with my daughter, which was so nice. And actually, it was really nice for her to enjoy the flight. A great first experience for her, really. That was until several weeks later when I happened to get a phone call from the flying club to say that they'd had a letter from the CAA, which is never words that you want to hear. They'd had a complaint about some low flying that I was allegedly involved with in the aircraft that I'd rented from the flying club. They'd had a letter from a resident of the area where we were flying to say that they'd spotted this particular aircraft flying at 150 feet above the ground in a reckless manner, and they've complained to the CAA about it, who then had obviously spoken to the flying club as the registered owners of the aircraft to find out who was flying it and what was going on. I mean, my first thoughts on getting that phone call was 150 feet? Like, who flies a plane at 150 feet? That is ridiculously low. It's lower than the height of a lot of buildings, so you know, unless I was landing with bits of washing up people's washing lines on the wings, then I don't think there's any way that I was flying at 150 feet above the ground. But I went back through my SkyDemon log to get the exact data from the flight and was able to provide it to them. So the rules for low flying in the UK are pretty simple. Essentially, you're not allowed to fly within 500 feet of any man-made object, and that goes up to 1,000 feet if you're over a built-up area. I wasn't below either of those. The other rule is, of course, that you've got to be able to glide clear if the engine stops, which, again, in this case, I was over fields, so I'd have been able to glide clear and land in any of those fields, and that was the plan if anything had gone wrong in the front. I wasn't anywhere near any of those heights above the ground. The ground in that area is at around about 400 feet in elevation, which means that at my height going into that of 1500 to 1600 feet, I was well above any minimum requirements. The fact that I was over the fields at that moment in time, by the time I was over the houses, I was even higher. I was up to 2000 feet, having climbed that 500 feet in the little turnaround that I did there. So I wasn't anywhere near the minimum height, which was pretty good. And certainly nowhere near the 150 feet that this guy had complained about in the letter to the CAA. So really there was absolutely nothing wrong with that, and I just provided the entire track logs from my flight to the flying club, who essentially then forwarded them on to the CAA, and they came back and said, look, you know, there's clearly no evidence that you were anywhere near that height that the person had alleged. They hadn't got any photographic evidence, and I just got my track log that proved that I was above that height at all times. Did kind of make me think though that although I do this track log every single flight that I do, I need to be making sure that that is definitely running on every flight that I do, because it's the only evidence I had to prove that I was above the minimum height on that flight. They could have even looked at flight radar, which showed me at that high altitude anyway on that flight. But even still, having that track log there was just really nice to be able to send to them and say, look, I was above the minimum height required. Here's my proof of that. This is the flight in question. This is what I was doing. And there we go. But there's something else that I've learned from this as well, and that is, as much as you can fly above the minimum heights and fly within regulations at all times, you're still going to have that human element who is going to want to put in a complaint about you at any given opportunity. And for that reason, the lesson that I'm taking away from this is just try not to piss people off. It's something that you try to do all the time anyway. Aviation, you're always going to get people having a go at you for one thing or another. Not giving people a reason to be able to have a go at you is probably the best bet going forward. For that reason, just try not to annoy people, really. So yeah, it's a bit frustrating that I got reported to the CAA for this, despite having done nothing wrong. It's just another hurdle. People, you know, people do this sort of thing all the time. When I used to fly many years ago, even then, people living in the local villages would complain to the airfield about planes flying over their house. And it still goes on even more so now with the advent of things like Flight Radar 24. People just go on there and can report you for anything that they feel like, just by getting the aircraft registration off of there. And it's just the era that we're living in, that we've got a lot of people with that sort of mentality out there. And it's sad, really. It really is, that people just can't let people get on with their lives and enjoy doing what they enjoy doing. But people are going to people at the end of the day. I hope you've enjoyed this video. I hope it's been useful for you. It's certainly been useful for me to be able to look back at what I did and to think about what I did and what I may do differently next time. But let me know in the comments down below your thoughts on this whole situation about people just reporting flights because they've seen you flying over on flight radar. I'd love to hear what your thoughts are down in the comments. In the meantime, as always, thanks for watching. Take care, and I'll see you on the next one. Bye for now. So how was that then?
It was good.
You enjoyed that?
Yeah. We'll get some food now, because I'm starving.
Yeah, we'll get some food on the way home, honey.
Get McDonald's.
If you want.